Now see the second question. ABCD is a rhombus and PQR and S are the midpoints. This is S, okay? Are the midpoints of the sides AB, BC, CD and DA respectively. Show that quadrilateral PQRS is a rectangle. Now this ABCD is a rhombus, that means its all sides will be equal, okay? P is the midpoint of AB, Q is the midpoint of BC, R is the midpoint of CD and S is the midpoint of DA. And PQRS is a quadrilateral. We have to prove that this PQRS is a rectangle. To prove that this is a rectangle, we have to prove that its opposite sides are equal and all the angles are equal to 90 degree. Okay, so first of all you will write what is given to you, then you will write to prove, okay, this you have to write yourself. Then you will write the construction. What construction we are doing? We have joined AC and BD, okay, these are the two diagonals of the rhombus and we know that the diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at 90 degree. Now see the proof. In triangle ABC, now in this triangle this P is the midpoint, Q is also the midpoint of AB and BC respectively. That means PQ will be parallel to AC and PQ will be half of AC by midpoint theorem. This we have studied in the previous class. So we will write P and Q are the midpoints of AB and BC. Therefore PQ is parallel to AC and PQ is equals to half AC. Reason will be midpoint theorem. Name this equation as equation number 1. Now see the above triangle, that is ACD. In this also R and S are the midpoints. So we will write R and S are the midpoints of CD and DA, okay? Therefore RS will be parallel to AC and RS will be equal to half of AC, again by midpoint theorem. Now name this as equation number 2. Now we can see that from equation number 1 and 2, in this AC is there and this also AC is there, that means these two will also be parallel. So from equation 1 and 2 we can write PQ is parallel to RS, and see this PQ is equals to half AC and RS is also equal to half AC, that means these both will also be equal. So PQ is parallel to RS and PQ is equal to RS, okay, that means this PQ is equals to this RS. And similarly we can prove that these two sides are also parallel and equal. So we can write similarly PS is parallel to QR and PS is equals to QR. Now since pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel, these opposite sides are equal and parallel, so therefore PQRS is a parallelogram, that means this PQRS is a parallelogram. Now in the above part we have proved that this PQ is parallel to AC by midpoint theorem. Now if these two lines are parallel, then their parts will also be parallel. So we can write since PQ is parallel to AC, therefore QN is also parallel to OM, okay, or OM is parallel to QN, okay, that means these two sides are parallel. Now again Q and R are the midpoints, that means QR will be parallel to BD. So we can write since BD is parallel to QR, this BD is parallel to QR, therefore their parts will also be parallel, that means this line will be parallel to this line. So we can write ON is parallel to QM, okay. Now in this quadrilateral ONQM, okay, in O N Q M if these two opposite sides are parallel and these two opposite sides are also parallel, that means this is a parallelogram. So we can write therefore O M Q N is a parallelogram because its opposite sides are parallel. So at last we can write, we know that the diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles. Now what are the diagonals of rhombus? AC and BD. Now they bisect each other at 90 degree. So this angle will be equal to 90 degree. This will be 90, this will be 90 and this will be 90. Now if this angle is equals to 90 degree, then if this is a parallelogram, then its opposite angle is this one. And we know that opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. That means this angle will also be equal to 90 degree. So since the diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angle, therefore angle MON is equals to 90 degree. Okay, and if this is 90 degree, then this will also be 90 degree. So then angle MQN is also equals to 90 degree. Reason is opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay, now see, we have proved this angle as 90 degree. So similarly, we will write that this angle is also 90 degree, this angle is also 90 degree and this angle is also 90 degree. Okay, by taking this quadrilateral and this quadrilateral. Okay, so no need to prove it once again. You can write it by writing similarly. Okay, so similarly, angle RSP equals to angle SPQ equals to angle SRQ equals to 90 degree. Now, if all these angles are equal to 90 degree and we have proved above that opposite sides are equal and parallel, that means this is a rectangle. So at last we can write, hence PQRS is a rectangle. Thank you everyone. If you like my videos, please like, subscribe and share my channel and stay connected with A1 Study Classes.